Today you're going to learn how to improve your audio quality inside Premiere, meaning that if you have any kind of podcasting or voiceover that you want to improve, then we're going to go and do that in this episode. So as you can see in front of me here, I have Premiere open with a new project, and inside Premiere, I dragged and dropped a piece of footage or an audio file of me saying this is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. So what I want to do here is, if you have Adobe Audition, then I'm going to go ahead and show you guys first how to get rid of any kind of background noise using Adobe Audition. If you don't have it, then don't worry too much about it, because we're not going to use the footage we run through Adobe Audition, because I want to prove to you guys that we can still remove background noise inside Adobe Premiere only. Okay, so what I want to do here is I want to right click my untitled audio file, and I want to open it with Adobe Audition. And yes, I do realize you can go inside Premiere, right click on the file, and edit directly in Adobe Audition. Just not going to do that. And inside Adobe Audition, we can go and select part of the file that has no sound in it, or at least no audio of me speaking in it. So what I do here is I select some of the background noise. Because there's no speaking here, the only thing that is going to be in this section is background noise. So I'm going to go ahead and say Control-Shift-P or Command-Shift-P if you're on Mac. And inside of here, I can go ahead and capture the noise print, meaning that I'm going to try and analyze how much noise is in this selection here. Then I'm going to select the entire file. And as you can see in the background, everything got selected. And I'm going to go ahead and reduce the noise by a certain amount. And I'm also going to go ahead and reduce a certain percentage of the noise that I hear. Now, a rule of thumb here is that you don't want to overdo these settings too much, because then it's going to sound kind of robotic. So I set mine to around 85-86% in the top one, and the bottom one I set to 40 decibels. Then I'm going to click apply. And again, it really does matter which clip you're using, because some audio clips need certain tweaking, and it really does change quite a lot from audio to audio. So you can't just use the settings that I'm using here. You have to kind of fiddle around with it yourself. But this is really what I usually do when it comes to Adobe Audition for all my audio clips. And this should actually take care of all the background noise you might have inside your clip here. Now, like I said, I'm not going to use this footage here, because I want to prove that inside Adobe Premiere we can reduce the noise. But if you were to actually have Adobe Audition, then I do recommend that you export the new file and use that one instead. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is, inside Premiere, I'm just going to go ahead and drag and drop my audio clip, and we're just going to go ahead and listen to it. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. Okay, so we can hear a bit of background noise in the part where I'm not talking, and the audio is not as loud as it should be. It's not as clear as it should be, or as deep sounding as it should be. There's a lot of things wrong here. So what I'm going to go ahead and do here is, first of all, I'm going to go ahead and go inside my effects panel over here. I'm going to go ahead and search for a effect called mastering. And I'm going to go ahead and drag and drop the effect onto my clip here. Now, after I did that, I can then go up inside my effect controls window and click edit. You'll see that we get this small window where we can change the mastering effect that we just applied to the clip here. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and stretch out the window, because I can't see everything inside what is shown here. And another thing we want to do here is, I would like to loop my footage, so I don't have to restart it manually every time I want to listen to it. So you want to make sure you have the loop button underneath the preview window. If you don't have that, you can go and click the plus icon on the right side and just drag and drop the loop button out, and then click OK. So I want to select loop, and I also want to mark where I want the audio to start and where I want it to stop. Okay, so if I were to play it now. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. So you can hear we start looping the audio over and over again. So inside the effect here called mastering, there's a couple of things we want to do. First of all, I'm going to change the preset to subtle clarity. And I would like to be able to change the lows and the highs of my audio, meaning that I want to change the deeper sounding noises and the higher pitched noises inside the clip. So I'm going to go ahead and go down to the bottom and enable low shelf enable and high shelf enable. Because now, as I start playing the audio, I can start tweaking the highs and the lows, so I can get a little bit more clarity on my voice and a little bit more bass inside my voice. So I'm just going to go ahead and play it here and try and listen to how I try to just sort of listen to what I need to tweak, and then I go for something that sounds good. okay? Because I can't tell you guys that we need to put it exactly like this and exactly like this, because it's, like I said, it's going to be different for each clip that you use inside Adobe Premiere.
This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test.
Okay, so I think just around there it sounds good for this effect. Again, what I'm trying to get from here is a little bit more clarity of the voice and just, you know, a little bit more punch to what I'm saying. So after we did this, you may notice that we do also have some background echo that I want to get rid of. Now we have something up here called reverb, which is going to get rid of this, you know, hollow sound effect, like I'm recording inside an empty circle or an empty square with no furniture or something. And I'm going to go ahead and just sort of beef it up so you guys can hear that it actually gets worse. And then I'm going to go ahead and turn it down so you can hear that it gets better. So right now it's set to 20 as a default. So if I go ahead and play it.
1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test.
And now you can hear once I did actually dial it down to 0, it sounds so much better. Okay. Again, you can keep tweaking these and go back to it later on if you want to, but I'm just going to go ahead and keep it here for now. I'm going to close it down. And then I'm going to go ahead and go down to my effects panel and search for something called multi-band compressor. And it has to be the one called not obsolete, because the obsolete is going to get deleted at some point. So I'm just going to drag the new one onto my audio here. And I'm going to click the edit button. Now, what you're going to notice in here is a couple of things. First of all, let me actually go ahead and expand it so we can actually see what's going on. Like so. Now in here, you will notice that we have a couple of different colors. We have blue, orange, green, and purple. Now the blue one is the low and the purple is the high, and the orange and green are the in-betweens. So we have, you know, low, slightly above low, slightly below high, and then high. Okay. Now once I start playing the audio, you guys will notice that we do have some waves going on up here in the view up here. And each of these represents one of the colors that we have down here. Now, we're not really going to use the view up here too much. We're just going to sort of listen to what sounds good. But what you'll notice is that once I start playing the audio, I'm going to go ahead and tweak the slider over here downwards till we hit just about where the audio hits when it goes inside the decibel meter here. And after doing so, I'm then going to adjust the gain so we get a little bit more punch to the lows and the highs and so on. So it's just about turning it up and turning it down and just sort of listening to what sounds good or not. So I'm just going to go ahead and reset this one. Now, before we do it, though, there's one thing over here in the right side that we need to tweak as well, called the limiter. Now, have you ever recorded something and because you maybe scream into the microphone or speak a lot louder than you adjusted the settings for the microphone, then you're going to peak your voice, meaning that the decibel count over here is going to go up into the red, and then it's going to sound really bad when people listen to it. So what we need to prevent here is that the audio does not go above -3, because that's about the sweet spot we want to have the audio when we record something. Again, it's just really a rule of thumb that you want to have -3. So what we're going to do in here is we're going to set the limiter margin to -3, not -4, -3, which is going to make sure that the audio does never go above -3. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and play the footage, and then I'm going to go ahead and tweak these sliders, and you'll notice that I take one at a time, I put it down to where the audio hits inside the decibel counter, and then afterwards I'll then gain it a certain amount.
This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. This is a test, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is a test. test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test.
Okay, so I think that sounds just about right. So if we were to go ahead and just sort of listen to it before and after applying the multiband compressor, we can do that by clicking the button up here in the top left corner, which is just going to turn it off, and then I can click it again to turn it on again. So we can just sort of loop it and then hear the difference here.
This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is a test. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test. This is.
So what you're going to notice here is that we get a slightly bit more punch to the different lows and the highs in order to give it just a slightly better sound inside, you know, when we're listening to it. So again, you can adjust these as much as you want. If you want to turn some of the ones down, you can do that as well. But I think I found just around the sweet spot here for what I'm actually editing here. So I'm just going to go ahead and close it down. Now, there's one more thing we're going to do, because we do have some background noise that I want to get rid of. Now, if we were to just go ahead and select the first and the right before I start speaking and loop it, you can hear there's quite a lot of background noise, because I'm actually sitting at a place with a highway behind me. There's a tent on the other side. So there's quite a lot of noise going on in the background where I'm sitting here. So what I can do is I can go inside Audio Track Mixer. And if you don't have this one, don't get this one confused by Audio Clip Mixer. This is called Audio Track Mixer. If you don't have it, go up inside Window in the menu and click Audio Track Mixer. Now, once you open it, it's probably not going to look like this. It's probably going to look like this. Just go ahead and click the arrow on the left side and drop it down. And afterwards, you can go ahead and either select audio track 1, 2, 3, or master, again, depending on how many audio clips you do have available to you. If I were to go down to my timeline, you can see that I have 1, 2, 3, and then the master is going to be all the tracks at the same time. So what I want to do here is I want to go ahead, and in this case, I can just go ahead and select the master. And I want to choose Noise Reduction Restoration by clicking the drop-down arrow inside the gray field. After I do that, I can then go ahead and right-click on the effect, click Edit. And then inside here, the one we want to focus on is the one called Noisiness. Now, what we want to do here is essentially we want to say, okay, how much of the noise do you want to remove? And the higher we slide it up, the more noise it's going to reduce. And the amount of noise it's then going to pick up and reduce, it's going to reduce by the amount that we have set up here, which is 20 decibels. So we're to play the audio. You can actually hear that it practically goes away straight away. Now, I can beef it up if I want to get rid of a bit more. And again, you don't want to overdo it, because then you're going to get some weird sounding robotic voice inside the audio. So I'm just going to go and select something that sounds just about good. So around 60. Going to go and close it. And what you can actually hear, if I were to just stop it and play it again, is that we do have some loud background noise going on in the beginning. And then as it starts moving, it's going to then, by time, take some of the noise away. So we have noise in the beginning, which then becomes no noise after a while, which is not really what we want. So the way we need to get rid of the first noise at the beginning, again, it is called adaptive noise reduction, meaning that it's going to adapt to it over time and then fix it as time goes on, as it starts moving inside the timeline down there. Now, the reason that we did actually insert the effect inside the audio track mixer is because it's going to go ahead and add the effect to everything inside the clip. If I were to go ahead and choose it as an effect down here and drag it onto my clip, if I start cutting in my video, it's going to do that thing where it's really loud in the beginning, and then it's going to adaptively reduce the noise as time goes. It's going to do that every single time you do an edit or a cut inside your timeline. And that's why we want to add it inside the audio track mixer and not inside the timeline down here as an effect. So what I want to do here is I want to go at the beginning of my clip here, and I want to go inside effect controls, and I want to set a volume. I'm just going to go ahead and add a keyframe. Then I'm going to go in a few frames, and then I'm going to go ahead and add another keyframe. Then I'm going to go to the beginning and just sort of drag it down. Because remember, even though we have reduced the noise, it's still going to analyze the audio track, even though we technically reduced it up here. And it's still going to go and remove the background noise. So it's going to go ahead and adaptively remove the background noise of the clip that we don't actually hear inside the preview. Like so. As you can hear when I start playing it, you can't actually hear it. Which is really nice. So this is how we can remove background noise and improve our audio quality inside Premiere. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I just want to say thank you for all the support you've given me on YouTube and give out a huge thanks to the people on Patreon who supported me on Patreon on a monthly basis. And if you're new and you don't know about Patreon, you can go ahead and click on the link in the description of this video and it'll take you to my Patreon where you can pay a small amount every month either to support me or to download the lesson material for my lessons here on the channel. So I hope you guys will take the time to go and check that out, and I hope to see you guys next time.